Welcome to the Kitchen with the Spice Gal. Today we are making pinwheel tortillas. We're going to make them two ways, the really healthy way and then the semi-healthy way. Someone had asked about making some things that you could take to parties. This would be one of those things. So first off, the things that we're going to be using today, for the really healthy version of these, we're going to be using zucchini ribbons as our tortillas. And I've got this little gadget, it's a peeler that peels in nice big strips. I'll put the link to this product in the comments. Anyway, so we're going to use those. And then I wanted to use these tortillas, they're Ezekiel tortillas, but I could only find the small ones and I really need the large ones. So I settled for something I've never used before, these gluten-free brown rice tortillas. Probably not as healthy. My family does really well on Ezekiel bread and Ezekiel tortillas, even though there's gluten in it. I don't know how to explain this. I guess it's not really from the bad kind of wheat that causes problems with a lot of people with gluten intolerance. Anyway, I'm going to put these back in the freezer. Okay, so you're going to need 8 ounces of cream cheese, slightly warmed, which I've already done. We used organic black pitted olives. I cut those up. They're right here. All right, we've got some green onions, organic valley cream cheese, and then it calls for Rotel, the recipe, but I'm using Muir Glen diced tomatoes with fire roasted with medium green chilies. Nancy's organic sour cream. You're going to need 2 cups of shredded chicken breast, or if you want to do a chicken in the Instant Pot, just chop it up. Some cheddar cheese. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is get our, I forgot the main ingredient. Or maybe not the main ingredient, but one of the best ingredients. Okay, we're going to make this a couple of different ways. I'm actually going to do it in half batches because I want to show you the versatility of these spices. The first one I'm going to use, French onion mix and homestyle ranch by the Spice Gal. I'm going to use a little bit of each of those in one, and then I'm going to do more of a southwestern flavor. I'm going to use a little bit of Taste of Italy with the Paco's tacos. You don't have to, you could use one or the other. I just want to kind of play around with it, as this is kind of, you know, what we're doing. All right, so I'm going to mix in half of this cream cheese, so about 4 ounces. Put that in there. We're going to start mixing. Just use your mixer. If you've just got like a hand mixer, that's fine too. I'm going to do a couple of shakes. The wine is still in this. It's a new bottle. Okay, the one thing I do want to say really quickly is I forget this all the time and then I wonder what's going on. These are organic. There is no fillers, no junk, no added crap to these products. You have to remember to shake them up real good. Because of the no fillers and binders, they separate. The heavier ingredients obviously go to the bottom. The lighter ingredients stay on top. That is why when you buy the ranch, and specifically the Taste of Italy, there'll be a little bit of room in the top of your bottle. That is for this purpose, because you must shake those two specifically before using. So, you want to put, I didn't take the, see, I left the security lid. All right. Shake a little bit of that in. I probably just put 1/2 tablespoon in. And then I want to do the same with the ranch, but I'm going to shake that up really good too. All right. Can get that in there good. Okay, and then since it calls, the whole recipe calls for 8 ounces, I'm splitting it into two. I'm just going to do 1 cup of the shredded chicken. Okay, I'm in my own kitchen. No one else is eating this except me. I'm not taking it to a party. I'm just doing it to show you, so I'm going to use my hands. Put that chicken in there. That all around. A little bit of sour cream. The actual recipe that I'm going by doesn't tell you how much sour cream, it just says a dash of sour cream, so I'm going to do probably 1/2 tablespoon of sour cream. Put that in there. Okay, then we're going to mix in some of these green onions, however much you want, you know your tastes. And then some of these olives. All right. And then 1/2 can of this Rotel. Alright. mix that up really good. Okay, you want to just scoop down the sides because you do get quite a bit of that left. Okay. Now I haven't made these before with the zucchini option that I'm about to show you, so if it doesn't work out, we're just not going to tell anybody, okay? We'll keep it our secret. All right. I do want to add some of the cheese, very last, probably half that. Oh, my dog's trying to get out. Where are you going? Mix that in there. All right, I'm going to get this, all this stuff out of the way so you can kind of see what I'm doing. Right, chopping board. Wipe this up. All right, so I'm going to show you this. You guys see that? Oh yeah, we're ready to rock and roll, people in wrap. Oh, I can never do this. It's like I'm special. Like when it comes to this stuff, I don't know. They just didn't make it for. No, that just never works out. Again, I'm not a chef, so don't critique my whatever this is. Okay, so we're gonna lay one of these tortillas down. We are going to spoon this mixture on, and you're gonna layer it on there, slather it on there, but leave about an inch gap around the edge so that it doesn't come out the sides. Again, this is not something I ever do elegantly. Okay, I'm gonna get that on there. Then you probably actually don't need this much. I just put way too much on there, which you can take it off because you want to do a couple of these, right? So for your party, you're going to roll them up. I don't know if you guys can see this, but I've got it there. All right, so you want to start rolling. I have never used these brown rice tortillas, so I'm hoping they work out well. You get a little bit of extra on there, just grab your spatula, kind of run it down the side. You've rolled it up. You want to do it nice and tight, which I did not, so we'll do it on the next one. And then roll that up, because we're going to sit it in the refrigerator just to kind of set. I'll leave that there. Let's do another one. Oh, why does this never work? Ah, there we go. All right, again, let's get this out of the way. Okay, so we're gonna get our tortilla, brown rice tortilla. Layer this on there, leaving half an inch gap around the edge. Man, this looks, smells amazing. Must be those Spice Girl seasonings. All right. Now you want to roll really tight. These aren't as pliable as the Ezekiel tortillas that I usually use. In fact, they're actually starting to crack. So maybe these wouldn't be the best idea, but you get the point. If you use the Ezekiel tortillas, they'll stay a little more pliable. I guess you have to heat these up probably before you use them, like most gluten-free options. All right, so we're going to lay out some of this zucchini right like this. You're going to want some toothpicks. I've got some here. Have them ready. Okay. You're just going to do the same as you did kind of with the tortilla. Oh. Okay. See, I told you I'm not a chef. This is what happens to normal people in the kitchen. Stuff just doesn't go right. If you want to put... All right, so we start rolling. Never mind. I don't know where I was about to go with that. Okay, we get a toothpick. You have got your healthy version of a roll-up. Okay, we'll do another one. Perfect. I want to show you these actually up close. It's kind of similar to the, well, I've overfilled this one a little bit. But you're not using tortillas, you're using healthy goods. Healthy produce. Okay. All right, I'm going to use the same bowl. All right, we're gonna put the rest of this cream cheese in. All right. bit of sour cream, so about half a tablespoon. All right, to your Rotel. You want to drain this a little bit when you first open it. You don't want a lot of that liquid, just a little bit. Put the rest of that Rotel in there. Okay, I'm not Rotel, it's Muir Glen, but that's what the recipe calls for. Everybody knows what Rotel is. Okay, so we're gonna put a cup of chicken, cup of our chicken in. Again, these aren't going anywhere, so I'm using my hands because no one but me is gonna eat them. Or my kids, well, they don't care. The olives, leftover olives, some green onion, throw that in there. However much you want, there's no method to measuring this out. We're gonna mix that up and then we're gonna, well, I'm gonna add my seasonings in just a minute, but I'm gonna mix it. Okay, now for this one, I wanna add a tiny bit of the Italian flavor because it's got some undertones that I like. Oh, I didn't shake that up. Again, remember to shake this up. And you'll be able to tell kind of when you open it, all those heavy ingredients are sitting on top. Probably a teaspoon of that. And then I'm going to use Paco's Tacos really lightly, but I'm going to do it until it covers the entire, there we go, for that southwestern flavor. All right, we're going to mix that up real good. Okay, and then right before the end, we're going to put the rest of this cheese in. And the magical dish fairy is going to even clean up those dishes later. Just kidding. I hope he does. Nutri-Man. Okay. I'm now done with that. You can see that mixture ready to go. Yeah. Okay. And we'll cut these up later so you can see them. You can kind of see these little pinwheels here, not the most attractive things. I probably could have done a lot better of a job rolling those up, but I'm trying to do it quickly for the video. These are all rolled up, ready to go in the fridge, and we're gonna pull them out in probably about an hour and cut them up. You take bites, not the entire thing.
God, that's good.
You like them?
Dude,
why are you shoving it in there?
That's good.
So, we'll make those again?
Yeah.
Okay. What are you doing?